Dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. Today I am going to discuss a new topic for the PG course in Environmental Sciences, that is Geo-relational and Object-oriented Data Structure. In this module, we are going to talk about concept of Geo-relational and Object-oriented Data Structure in GIS. Let's start with introduction. A model is a gross simplification of the real world. Spatial data is any data pertaining to space. Spatial data is stored in either a raster data model or a vector data model. The vector data model uses points, lines, and polygons to represent the real world. Thus, for storing, analyzing, and retrieving spatial data, it needs to be imported to GIS platform. Such representation of spatial data in either vector or raster format in GIS platform may have its own advantages and disadvantages, but are essential for carrying out analysis for spatial data. The spatial data and non-spatial information are stored within GIS platform in a structured or organized way. Geometrical shapes along with its attributes should be in synchronized way. In order to represent the spatial scenario, storing spatial geometry, spatial relationship among the spatial feature and their attributes makes it a challenging task. Since spatial and non-spatial data acts as base for all the analysis, queries, and processing, data management in a structured or organized way becomes crucial for developers. There are a number of such database management systems which provides efficient, quick, and conditional and space-saving capability within the GIS platform. The analytical and modeling capabilities of GIS make it ideally suited for solving complex management problems and helping in better decision-making. Data models should meet the following criteria. First one is generality. Second one is simplicity. Next one is efficiency, adaptability, freedom from restrictions. Now come to geo-relational data structure. Geo-relational data structure stores vector data for a geographic coverage which includes its spatial and attribute component. Spatial data describes the location of spatial feature, whereas attribute data describe the characteristics of spatial features. Geo-relational data structure organizes the data into split system, which means it stores the spatial data into graphic files and attribute data into relational database. As we know that the vector data uses geometric objects of points, line, and polygon to represent spatial feature. Spatial representation of spatial feature is complex as their point, line, and polygon relation on Earth are not simple. Therefore, topology acts as set of rules to define the interrelationships among spatial feature. Coverage does also possesses the same feature to define rules to define the interrelationship among spatial feature. There are packages embedded within GIS platform to define a spatial set of rules among the geometrical objects. Now it becomes clear that geo-relational data structure requires the following in order to maintain data integrity and consistency. Spatial data into geographic files and attribute data into relational database coverage or topological set of rules. Graphic file, relational database, and coverage or topological files assigns common ID, that is identifier, to particular feature class and its associated topological and attribute files. This identifier acts as identity for that particular feature and its association with other spatial features. Using the common ID data can be synchronized and processes like query, analysis, and display in union can be performed. Most of the GIS platforms are equipped with georelational data structure. In this figure, we can see that structure of georelational data. Now come to object-oriented data structure. The object-oriented data structure is designed using relational DBMS with object-oriented extensions. This data structure has robust management capabilities of RDBMS along with access of object-oriented system. Complex column structures can be defined using object-oriented and RDBMS. Object-oriented data model stores spatial and attribute data together rather than in a split system. This model also allows spatial feature to be associated with properties and methods where proper is an attribute or characteristics of an object and method is a specific action that can be performed on an object. Object-oriented data model stores data at two separate layers, namely geographic and geometric object layer. Generally, object data model at higher level is known as geographic object data model. The geographic objects, virtual objects, and a set of semantic spatial functions, retrieval functions, set functions, and aggregate functions are termed as geographic object data. It also has a set of functions for retrieval, manipulation, and computation of geometric objects. Lower level data model is known as geometric object data model, which consists of primitive, geometric, and virtual objects. Geometric objects are actual spatial representations of geographic objects such as polygons, nodes, and edges. Spatial computation creates geometric objects. Object-oriented functional query language, that is OFQL, interface for the database access has been embedded within the system for the more complex calculations. The model provides abstractions and functional independence between the geographic and geometric object data model. Each model has its own set of object classes, object and functions. The parent and child relationships within the model is represented by part of relationship and is a abstraction. The model takes care of the part of relationship and is a relationship by introducing various functions for resolving the containment topological relationship. In this figure, we can see that structure of object-oriented data model. Object-based data model is built on four basic concepts of abstractions. These are classification, generalization, association, and aggregation. Let's start with classification. It is the process to map objects instances onto a common class. Object is defined as a single occurrence of data about individuality and observable behavior. The object-oriented approach, every object is considered as an instance of class. Therefore, classification is also termed as instance of relationship. And type defined the behavior of its instances by operators which manipulates the objects. In right panel, we can see that graphical representation of classes. Next one is generalization. This combines many classes of objects with common operators into general superclass. Superclass defines the grouping and its relation with subclass. Subclass and superclass is abstraction of same class. Further, superclass may have multiple subclasses and at multiple levels. Subclass may act as superclass for some classes. Third one is association. It defines the relationship among independent objects which mate by higher level of set objects. Set defines the association and members, that is associated objects. Therefore, this abstraction process is termed as member of relation. Last one is aggregation. This explains about composed objects, which mean that a group of objects may form a semantically higher level object and it termed as aggregate or composite objects. Aggregate operation is not compatible with part operation. The relation defined by aggregation is termed as part of relation. Aggregation applied to components generates aggregate type data structure. Inheritance and propagation are very crucial while modeling the complex object behavior. Object-oriented data modeling can serve the purpose of suitable spatial information system. This modeling approach can be applied at all the stages of large complex software system. This approach, particularly abstract mechanism, is necessary to model the complex situation such as geometric objects. In left panel, we can see that a city model as aggregate. To summarize this module, we can say that the spatial and non-spatial information are stored within GIS platform in a structured or organized way. Geometrical shapes along with its attribute should be synchronized way in order to represent the spatial scenario. Since spatial and non-spatial acts as base for all the analysis, queries, and processing, data management in a structured or organized way becomes crucial for developers. There are a number of such database management systems which provides efficient, quick, and conditional and space-saving capability within the GIS platform. Georelational data structure store the data in a split system, while object-oriented data model stored the data in a single system. Object-oriented data got upper hand in synchronizing the spatial and non-spatial data along with its spatial relationship. Dear students, hope this session would have given you an insight into the topic. Thank you and bye for now.